hold on.
Television.
Which one? Those two. The two of them. Yeah.
By Dr. Barnes Wallace as part of the Vickers. So he flies very much part of his family life. So we wait to tie them off, and then later on we shall see the gypsy moth. I'll tell you more about that when it's here. The tiger moth should be here within the next 5 minutes. Going back to his books, the Jeffrey de Havilland says, I quote, the aeroplane has not yet developed to the stage, this is in the 1930s, not yet developed to the stage where it can be used like a car, but moth odors came very near to it in the practical use of their aeroplanes. It was quite usual to fly to a place one wished to visit and land in the nearest suitable field, turn the aeroplane down with screw pickets and then get permission from the farmer to land in his field, and there was seldom any trouble. That's for another loop. There is a stop. That is itself exhilarating in advance. Well, Ralph has just called goodbye, so thank you, Ralph Hubbard. And look to your left, ladies and gentlemen, and we see the gypsy moth. And this has a Gypsy 2 engine. This aircraft actually went to Denmark when it was new. It's owned by Mr. Roy Palmer, who's a local man in Weybridge, and an enthusiast about restoring beautiful things, and particularly aeroplanes with heritage like the Gypsy Moth. That engine sounds different. It's actually got a better silencer. The Tiger Moth has exhaust stubs. This has got a silencer. It's quieter. Looks very much the same, but of course the Tiger Moth was a development of it. So perhaps we can marvel at the achievements of the great de Havilland aircraft company in what they produced 80 years ago and more with these magnificent airplanes, and what a delight it is to see them so beautifully restored and in fine condition and in the air and not sitting in a museum. Some of them sit in museums, but here's one that doesn't. Well, that's the end of the Gypsy Moth's time on our display line. He's returning to base at White Newton. And that brings our very short but historic flying display to an end, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you've enjoyed seeing those two magnificent airplanes, very well flown. Thank you for your attention and enjoy the rest of the day.